Bada bing, bada boom, your mom looks like King Jong-un. Welcome back everybody to another ARC series. Today we're going solo on Zavi's Trios. I actually got a really good, nice early start. As you can see here, I got pretty good flak early on. I also have a shotgun, as you can see. This was between, I don't know, 30 an hour into white. And I already get into some early PvP. I end up blowing his PT here and just getting in a bullet fight. This guy's got Ghillie, I don't know what he's really doing. But I end up bowling him and then absolutely destroying him. Can't really have much, but you know, first kill already, so that was pretty nice. And then I decided to progress, and it was pretty easy to progress. As you can see, I have riot gear on now. I almost died here, it was kind of scary. I somehow killed the spiral in the midst of all that, by the way. But I do end up hitting level 100 pretty quickly. I was probably the first one here, to be honest. I wouldn't say the first one to hit 100, but definitely the first one to get to these spinos, because they were all freshly spawned. Then I ended up needing to farm electronics, so I came back here. But I ended up finding this guy who was trying to run away from me. I knew he had some loot on him because I saw him farming an enforcer, so even though he's naked and he looks like an absolute bob, it was definitely worth killing him. And as you can see, he had some electronics, just what I needed. Also, the servers were really laggy at this time, so you'll see a lot of lag. They're capped, as usual on wipe day. But I need to heal up my stalker, so I end up trying to kill this Fiomia. And in the right, top right of your screen here, you actually see this little white marker. And I noticed it, and I knew this guy saw me. And he looked, as you can see here, he tries to hide from my ass, but I knew he was in there. And also another thing, by the way, I had a really good stalker. Like 216 was really rare, to be honest. So, you know, my start was just going really well. I ended up setting up a base and I got some heavies up. I think I had two at this time. It was still probably maybe an hour into wipe by now. And I found some juicy raids I had to do. And they had no turrets, so it was definitely worth it. And I knew my base would be protected because nobody would be able to run this. Now the first base takes place on this little island here, and all of these raids were online, by the way, so you know, you can't hate on me. They're all 1v1s, but they're online. As you can see, this guy's in his base right now. I totally expected to get the C4 glitch, but I didn't, so that was pretty nice. I blow in and this guy immediately gets on his Maywing and jumps away. I'm like, alright, whatever. So I start to break in the shit because I know there's loot's all in here. He comes back, starts pounding me with the main wing. I'm trying to pick, but I can't hit him. And I finally get him off, but I end up letting go. This guy brings out a shotgun. Now one thing that's annoying about stalkers and shotguns is that you can't always pick when you're getting shot. As you can see, I'm not getting my red light around the highlight around the character here. So I can't pick him. That's why I'm swatting him. Obviously, if I stopped, I could. Now I have it, and I could do it, and I end up fucking doing it, but I just let go again, so that was nice. I'd go after him here, because I thought he was pretty low, but I don't think he actually was. He gets on his Maywing anyways, and he ends up just bowling out of here, so I'm like, you know what, whatever. There's no point in me chasing him when all his loot's in this base. So I get to work here. Everything's already destroyed. A ton of refining forges, by the way. Put the stalker on neutral just in case he does come up behind me. I know I quickly LB everything, but all this loot was pretty worth it. He had quite a bit of metal as well. And all of a sudden I hear him come back. He tries to bowl on me and misses. His Maywing gets in the way here and it kind of pissed me off. I end up do bowling him somehow. And yeah, I do kill him. He had a really shit Maywing as well, so, you know, I could have probably just shotgunned that. He had a pretty decent kit, but nothing too hot. And then I went over to probably the best spot on Crystal, but who knows. This guy was building it, and I saw it was a pretty easy raid. I'm pretty sure this is 6x, so I don't know why I placed so much T4, but it's alright. I had a ton of resources. Almost fall off here, but quickly react. I don't know how the guy didn't hear me, by the way, but whatever. Killed his PT, so now it's just him in there. I quickly get in, and I see his red marker for a second. I end up picking him, or trying to pick him, but I get off, and he hits this insane bola, which I think that was pretty clean. But I end up making an even better bola over the fence, or the pillar. I'm trying to hit him, and I'm barely hitting him in the head. And I end up killing him because, well, I could barely hit him, but it was a nice kill. He didn't have much, but it was pretty worth it. I wish I could take that base spot over, but I did not have the resources at that time. I did find this other base here in this pretty nice spot. This guy was also home, so another PvP time. Instantly blow it up and get in here. I thought he'd be on his PT, but apparently not. I don't even think he noticed until, yeah, there. He gets up pretty quickly. He tries to get on his PT, and I instantly bolo that. I thought he was going to run out here, but he decided not to. That's why I was so passive on my stalker. My bolo would just not throw, by the way. I don't know if you guys just saw that. Here I start panicking, and I noticed I was in first person, which I just don't like. I was trying to whistle neutral here. My stalker did end up getting him. And I missed another bolo, so that was nice. Sometimes the best thing to do is punch, because it kind of gets rid of their aim. He breaks my pants, so I start to panic quite a bit. But, you know, I can't instantly go in because he could one-shot me. So I decided to just not until I get on my stalker, so now I can throw on some pants. I'm trying to avoid this guy's shots here so I can get my stalker cooldown off. I bolo the PT again because I don't want to deal with that and get meshed. And I realize, well, I could just pick him now pretty easily. He gets out again, but I do end up bowling him. I absolutely destroy him, but I know I LB'd the kit there, but it was pretty juicy. Nothing really in these from what I remember, but we'll see. The metal, I don't think there's much there either. Yeah, nothing. There's nothing. And then I go over to Sunny, and I get tech 10 grams. Don't worry, I passed the boss. I know I didn't show it, but I promise I did. I raid this little base. Didn't really have much. Then I go over to Extinction to get more electronics, and I find this guy. I absolutely destroy him with the bola here. This guy got really triggered when I killed him, but I thought it was pretty funny. I only saw him too because I had to wait cooldown, as you can see from my cryo timer. That's why. I don't even know why he was looking in that bag, but alright. Then I went over to this desert base, which was, as you can see, pretty easy to raid if I just placed a C4 on it, but there's three people here this time. So it's a little bit harder, and I didn't want to just get off because if I got bullied, it'd be pretty easy to die. And I actually do end up getting bullied, which is pretty scary because now there's three people plus two stalkers on me now. Thank God one of them was using flame arrows. I can counter that pretty easily with Wyvern Milk. But look at this melee bob over here. Absolutely rails me. Thankfully, I get his pike. I thought I was gone right there. I mean, if I didn't whip it, it would have been over. I'd get out of the bola. I thought that was my stalker, but I realize it's over here. And I get on, and I knew there's no point in me staying here, so I end up just jumping away. I do get out of this, barely, but I do get out. Then a friend has a fight with this guy, and we actually kill him twice. But the reason I'm so late in this clip, because I had Ebola, but he just didn't fucking die, so that was nice. And now he's just shotgunning my stalker. This guy was a tank for no reason. I really don't know what's going on here. But I do end up picking him again. And I knew he was going to kill my stalker, so... But then he tries to bull me. I get on my stalker because I thought I could pick him, but... Now my stalker's eating me. It won't even give me a red icon, so that was nice. And he kills my stalker. But I do end up killing him literally right after, like a split second after. He had a pretty nice kit. I had cinnamon crop eggs and Maywing eggs from him, so that was nice. You know, donated a pretty nice kit there. Now, this is where I die, kind of. I kill a guy, but then I go in the guy's base and I die. So, you know what? It's whatever, but I do want to show the clip. I don't die by this guy. I die by a different guy. He had questionable aim, but I think he's just a really MTS arena sweat, so I'll give it to him. But he did kind of destroy me, not gonna lie. So I'm not even gonna show it. I do kill this kid though, and he had a pretty nice kit, but like I said, I don't really get it out because I do end up dying. This just comes to show, by the way, how good you could be if you just had a decent stalker right away. Because Leia was unstoppable up until this point. I did get a boss locker egg and a trike egg off him. I didn't even know that base existed. Now this next raid, I promise you it was online, but I didn't show the clip where I killed him, but I promise you I did kill him. But this guy really didn't have much anyways, so it doesn't really matter. He was on like the pillar, not pillar. Floating island right where the Pearl Lake is for Crystal, so if you know where that is, you can kind of imagine it. I end up getting element, which took a hell of a time to farm that up on extinction, but I end up do getting it. I do LE dust with a Dodek, I don't know why. I'm a little dumb. And here is the main storyline. These guys, this tribe. So, they live right below me in this little rat hole. And I find one of them. I found they're building up. This guy hits an insane bola, by the way. Like, that was... I'd give it to him. He, like, hopped off his Maywing and instantly bowled me. So, you know what? That was pretty nice. I do end up whipping the shotgun, as you saw. And I knew I could kind of get out of this. They weren't really doing much damage. Flame arrows don't really do that much when I got that resistance boost. Sorry. Whipping out of the stalker, which I didn't even know was a thing, but whatever. And I realized, well, it's a 2v1. There's really no point in me staying here. I end up bolting out of here. But I do come back on multiple occasions. And we end up having a little scramble and perhaps an online raid for me. But I wanted to show the base. It's actually terrible. I don't know why I'm showing it, but this was day one, so you know what? I'm proud of myself for getting tech day one, because I usually don't do that, especially as a solo, but you know what? I did it. Like, I saw nobody else with tech on this map. I mean, there's Bob on this map, but what do you say? This is only part one to this series. In the next part, we do online raid them, but I hope you guys enjoyed.